So hello and welcome to the Some People Review, and today we'll be looking at the, Peaky Peaky fifth single, even though I said we'd be taking a bit of a break, but it's going to be a bit more of a break for you than it is going to be for us.
Yes, that's right. So by the time this comes out...
It'd be sometime in, I'd say early to mid-January?
Yeah, mid-January.
And we're recording this in like mid-December.
Yes.
And I think this came out like, what's the release date? Yeah, like late November.
Mm.
So we're a bit late to the party, but that was the whole point, was kind of take a break from it. Well,
yes.
Like, I probably wouldn't have taken a break from covering it, but I thought it'd be like nice just to work on some other things instead of working on this, as well as giving the audience a bit of a break. But
yeah,
I guess it's not going to be as much of a break because Pussy Road thought it'd be a good idea to be like, oh yeah, we're bringing out a fifth single just shortly after we wrap up recording of the last of the fourth or second to the last fourth single review we did, which I can't remember which one's list because we're going to have... release them in a bit of a scrambled order.
Yes.
I think we do bring it up in one of them, though.
Essentially. I don't remember. But
either that, we might cut it out.
Yeah. I guess, yeah, this does kick off the start of the fifth singles review series. So,
yay.
Good one to start us off with.
It is, yeah, some peaky.
Yeah.
But I was hoping to kind of, before doing the fifth singles, to kind of go back and revisit some of the older ones, which we've kind of done with Peaky Peaky, but do it for the other units as well.
Yeah.
But I guess that's not going to happen.
Yeah, just didn't work out.
Hopefully by the time we finish the singles, we actually can actually have time to cover the older ones, if not even have a short break after the fifth singles before covering the older ones.
Yeah.
Why should we say that? And then it's like, fifth single just around the corner.
Yeah.
Although we haven't actually announced the name of the single, which is, pardon my pronunciation, Minatsu no Instant, or in English, Midsummer Instant.
Yes.
I find it funny I had more trouble pronouncing it in English than in, its native tongue, which
yeah,
I just find funny.
Yeah. Should we get into this?
Oh, yeah. Episode? I was going to say, what you think it's going to be like? I have a feeling it's going to be good, but that's because in Peaky Peaky, we trust.
Yeah.
Well, I should say I trust.
Well, I would say going off of the title of both the single and the A-side.
Well, just having bad trouble with English today.
Oh, yeah. I feel it's going to be pretty upbeat and bright sort of sounding overall. So that's what I'm looking for. Expecting, but I guess we'll see.
Yeah, well, I guess we should dive into it then.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess, I was going to take charge, but nah, that's normally your job.
So definitely very, very bright and summery vibes, I would say.
Oh, with a name like that, it should be.
Yeah, I would say not as upbeat as I was expecting. Definitely much more of a laid-back feel.
I was going to say, yeah, it's a bit tame for a Peaky song. Yeah,
it definitely is. Like, there was some moments here and there where, like, the music is getting, like, chopped and cut up in some interesting ways, which is very, like, Peaky Peaky-esque. But, yeah, like, overall, not quite the Peaky vibe that I think we're used to.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Which I guess is probably not a good start if, well...
I guess so, yeah, if you're expecting, you know...
some good old Peaky, but...
Yeah.
I still find it enjoyable either way so far.
Yeah, I would say...
I think I may have heard it when I played this, well, but, well, cleared the song in Groovy Mix, like, shortly after it was released in the game.
Yep, yep. Yeah, so, interesting. I mean, we've still got the rest of the song to go, two-thirds of it, so...
Oh, we're actually that far into it.
Yeah, we're a third so far.
Doesn't feel like it.
Yeah.
Which is weird because it's not really that fast-paced or aggressive as a song. It just, I guess it just cruises on by quite quickly.
It does, yeah. That sort of, yeah, almost like driving along the, like a shorefront, beachfront sort of thing. Yeah, it's, the pacing of it is very laid back. And it kind of does have that feeling of, yeah, it doesn't feel like it's already been a minute and a half or something. So, yeah, I'm interested to see where it goes from here.
I think we should continue on with it. God, this is actually a bit of an interesting song because I can kind of see like myself just what, chilling out on a sunny day on the beach with like a few cocktails just listening to this song.
It definitely brings,
like in the middle of summer.
Yeah, it definitely brings up those images of, yeah, sitting on the beach, you know, under a big beach umbrella and, yeah, just hanging out, not doing a lot and just enjoying yourself.
Which is weird because I'm actually not much of a cocktails person.
Yeah.
Although I think you're more of a cocktail type than I am.
Probably. Yeah.
I'm just happy with like what a bit of what whiskey and me coffee and that's about it.
you could say that's a simple cocktail. But yeah, I would say for overall for the song, you know, it's nice. It's definitely not what you expect coming from Peaky Peaky.
Yeah, definitely. But it kind of still sort of works.
It's a nice song. I would say, like, it's a good sort of transition or like in between song. So like after you've maybe listened to 6 or 8 or maybe 10 Peaky Peaky songs, to throw this in.
Just to kind of slow things down a bit.
Yeah, to get a little bit of something different, some variation in there, I think could work quite well.
I probably would have probably used Ultimate Vista.
Yeah.
Which actually is kind of a good in-between.
Yeah. But yeah, I guess this could be maybe after the 20th song or something like that. So yeah, it works in that instance. But yeah, if you're expecting, you know, big Peaky Peaky energy.
Yeah, you're going to be a bit, left a bit wanting.
Oh yeah.
I was going to say disappointed, but
yeah,
I mean. Well, it's kind of the same thing, isn't
it? Yeah, you could be a bit disappointed. Yeah. I would say, like, overall, there's only really two interesting things that sort of stood out to me. One is super subtle and you probably wouldn't have even picked up on it, particularly if you are listening through a set of stereo speakers. But on headphones, the hi-hat sound, it instead of, like, being stuck in one pan spot, it like moves around quite a bit, which was cool. So like pans from left to right and then goes center and then here and there, which is just a nice little touch,
like a nice bit of dynamic range.
Yeah just changes things ever so slightly.
Dynamic range. I was thinking like, no, it's not dynamic range, you idiot.
It's definitely part of it, that's for sure. Yeah, definitely affects the dynamic range a little bit. And then the bass sound as well, which was super super bright and like almost crunchy sounding in some spots, but also like the way that they've edited the bass tracks, you can sort of tell that it's like been chopped and changed and pieces moved around to make it this really almost sporadic kind of performance, which if it was played like that live, you'd need a really, really great bass player to really tackle that one, because there's a lot going on there. Other than that, like, the synth sounds are nice, the drum sounds are nice, but yeah, they're not necessarily anything too special or interesting, at least for me.
So I guess we're not off to a very strong start. Long story short.
Yeah. I would say,
let's see if the B-side can be a bit more peaky.
Yes.
God, why did I do that? There's no way, like, you can hear me wink. Yes. I like how I winked as soon as I said peaky. God damn it. Okay, so coming up next is We Never Lose.
Never Lose.
Why did I put a we in there? We're not French.
We.
So that was interesting.
Yes. Again, I'd say quite different to what we usually get from Peaky.
Oh, yeah. Peaky. This is more like not quite Mermaido. Who am I thinking of? It's kind of sort of a blend between like a mild Mermaido and like a more timid Happy Arando.
Yeah, I think that would fit that assessment definitely. Yeah, it's got like a bit more of a funky, upbeat sort of thing going
for it. I kind of dig it, though.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. It's interesting. It sort of like raises more questions than gives us answers when taking into account the A side as well. So it's
definitely
like,
different.
Yeah, definitely different. Definitely different. I was even going to say it sort of reminds me of a lot of the songs from the Persona series of games, because they do sort of like a bit of like a mix or fusion of like rock and funk, and it's got a little bit of that going for it, but definitely okay. More like synthesizer forward. But yeah, overall, again, it's something different, and I'm not quite sure where I stand yet.
I've kind of like, yeah, I'm enjoying it, but again, we're still only like, we really made it that far into the song.
Yeah. Min 20 in.
It's like, it doesn't feel like it. It's more like kind of like 40 seconds in.
Yeah.
Which is the same feeling I can get it with the A side, which I'm not sure if it's just me being a bit out of it or.
It is a little bit elusive again. I'm not sure. It might be the pacing. I think it could sort of just be like some of those classic sort of peaky songwriting and sort of mixing things that they do, where like a lot of the time there is just so much going on in the musicality. There's like always something moving, always something new happening. So it could just be, yeah, like because there's so much going on, you kind of lose track of how far you've gotten into the song.
Most likely.
Yeah.
Well, right. I guess we shall continue on with it then. Okay.
Oh, God. I definitely wasn't expecting a guitar solo in there. That really took me by surprise. I think we've gotten...
interesting.
Yeah, we've gotten guitar in Peaky Peaky songs before, but yeah, that like, just...
Overwhelm.
Yeah.
Although, isn't that more like a Spanish guitar at the start there?
It's still guitar, but yeah, definitely more in that style. But yeah, just wasn't expecting there to be a guitar solo at the midway point. It was interesting. Again, still not quite sure where I stand on this one.
I guess we should continue on because I don't have much more to comment, even though it is pretty nice to have it.
Yeah.
That's the B-side.
Yeah, that's it is definitely giving me more questions than answers.
Although I think you're kind of a bit on the money with the B-side having like more of a kind of a feel to like the songs and Persona.
Yeah, I think so. Which is
weird because I'm like super familiar with not only Persona as like an IP, but just the music with it. But even I can be like, yeah, you got a point there with the few tracks I've heard from Persona.
Yeah, yeah, definitely a lot of like the popular songs. Like I've never played the games, but I've listened to a little bit of the music. And yeah, a lot of the popular songs, they're either like sort of heavy rock, almost metal bass, and then like the other ones are definitely sort of like in that funk rock sort of style.
Although speaking of like good music in like Japanese games, some of the music they use in the Ace Attorney games is just amazing if you've played any of them.
No, I haven't.
Oh, you're missing out.
Back to Never Lose. I would say, like, overall, it's a nice song.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
I would say, like, if the A-side... It's actually
kind of similar to Deja Bun, if that's how it's pronounced.
Right.
From, it's not the most recent single, but this... Well, this is the most recent single, so it's not the one before this one, but the one before that one, I think.
Okay. Right. Yeah, I can't think of it at the moment.
I know Deja Bun's the first, from the first Peaky album.
Oh, okay.
Was it? I can't remember, which I should know this shit.
But yeah, like I would say if the A-side is the song that you're sitting on the beach, maybe having a few cocktails, just watching time pass by, I kind of feel the B-side is like...
kind of a warm-up to a party.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's exactly what I thought. I thought like you're now off the beach, you've freshened up and you're on your way to the party. That's kind of what I thought.
Although for me, for freshening up, we'd probably go to the pub and just smashing a few pints.
Yeah, not exactly what I was envisioning, but...
but that's something I totally would do.
So yeah, that's... I do kind of like how they... both the songs complement each other in that way. But I think, again, yeah, coming back to the fact that they are quite...
Different
and, yeah, sort of divergent to the regular Peaky sound. Like, it's nice that they're trying something different. Yeah. And it's not, like, a complete failure. Like, we've had... there's been some in the past where other units have tried doing something different and it just...
not quite panning out.
Yeah, it just falls flat. Well, yeah, these are definitely good songs. They're just not...
very Peaky.
Yes. So, yeah, I think that's my... Which, that's my overall review. All right. Should we have a look at the cover art?
Yes. I was just about to get to that, which I think right now we should have the standard, right?
Yep. So we got standard here. I think it fits quite well. Oh, yeah,
definitely.
Yeah, definitely listening to the songs now, I think thematically it fits pretty cool with both.
Not only that, but I just like the kind of the style of the artwork. It's just kind of even... the cover itself is kind of like an homage to how the early singles are.
Yeah, I would agree, actually.
With a slight new twist on the design.
Mm. Yeah, it definitely has that feel to it. It's definitely quite different from the fourth single, that's for sure.
Although reading at the text at the top can be a bit of a pain.
It is quite small.
But I do like how the name is, well... going from top to bottom, I find that a bit neat.
Yeah, that's cool. I like also that, like, it has, like, up here, it has it in Japanese, or how, like, yeah, you would phrase it in Japanese using the English characters. I think that's, like, a nice touch there.
But in the top left corner, I wanted to know why there's an 01.
That's what I was thinking as well. So I'm wondering if Happy Around's next, then will they be 02?
Okay. Well, I guess we'll have to wait and see.
Mm.
Well, I guess we should now move over to the special edition. It's actually not as nice.
Yeah,
which is weird.
I would agree. Like
normally it's nicer looking.
Yeah. Like you get the bigger picture of the unit.
Which helps it make it pop more, but all the detail you kind of lose from the standard is just...
Yeah.
It's even, well, it's actually, even though the text is small, it's actually easier to read.
It is a little bit easier to read the text on this one, but I definitely prefer the standard.
I think normally I tend to favour the special.
Mm.
Like this one, I'm kind of, they've both got their strengths and weaknesses, so I can't really definitively say, oh, this one's better. it's probably the case where I'd actually both buy the special and standard.
Mm. Like, I would say the only thing that I prefer about the standard is that the red border is even around the whole thing, whereas the white border here isn't.
So it's like, I do like having things being, well, not symmetrical.
Yeah.
It bugs me, but at the same time I enjoy it, which,
mm-hmm.
Well, but I probably also enjoy it because it bugs me as well.
Yeah. So, yeah, that's like, it's a very small gripe, but overall I do prefer the standard in this one.
Well, we can't rank it to the other fifths because none of them are out, so I guess it is both best and worst fifth single at this point.
Yeah. Yes.
Which is quite an interesting way to think about it.
Yeah.
Which I guess that kind of is everything we want to say about it, which...
Yeah.
It's weird because I'm kind of at a loss of words for this outro.
Well, I guess let us know your thoughts on Midsummer Instant.
Even you have a trouble with it.
I forgot the name there. But yeah, let us know your thoughts on Midsummer Instant by Peaky Peaky.
And just let us know how much you're looking forward to the other singles.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Not only that, but I just realised if we do the first singles, we're going to have to cover Unicord. Oh, God.
And yeah, if you don't know by now, Briggsy is not exactly a fan of
one Unicord. Particular character. It's not, I'm okay with the unit. It's just the one particular member of the unit that brings it down for me.
Yes. Let us know in the comments who you think that particular character might be.
Although I guess one of the positives is canonical lesbian couple, so I guess that's sort of a win.
Fair enough.
And yay, there's my obligatory mic punch, which I keep accidentally doing, which I'm not sure if you've edited those out, but...
I think so.
I think there's still a couple that made it its way through.
Maybe. And most of all, remember to give the video a like, share it around, and we'll see you next time.
Yeah, hopefully we'll be covering either another one of the fifths, or if it's not out by... the time we get back to record and stuff, we'll probably cover some of the older ones.
Yeah.
Briggsy out.